Visionary is a kind of person who see future, who knows the future, not only like foresee or think how it will be, but do. And visionary is a person who shares his vision with people, who implement this and through this make things happen. So that's why I call myself a visionary, because I know how it should be, and I try to make these things happen in future.
I want to hear about your vision, but I also want to hear, did you always have a vision? I mean, were you one of these people that was just born with this fixed idea in your head? You said, I want to go there.
I know it's a good question, because I was born in Pulkovskaya Observatory. It's one of the biggest observatory and the oldest in the world. So it's very well known, and my family, my aunt and my mother, they were well-known astrophysicists in Soviet Union. So back there, like, I always had these stories around me about galaxies, black holes, space and so on. And since childhood, I had this idea so clear inside me that space could be habitable. It could be habitable for people, it could be habitable for everyone, and it could be the way like we live here on the Earth, so like with trees, with cafes, with restaurants and so on. And I had this idea like that it's so normal. Of course, in school and in university, I wasn't so kept with this idea. I had different businesses and tries, but 2 years ago, I decided finally to do what I really want to do, to do what is my passion about.
Okay, so if we back up a minute and you tell me your vision is to make, your overall vision is to make space habitable.
Yeah. And to make habitable, not only in terms of, okay, like, let's go to the moon and put some flags there and make some cool photos. No, not in that way. It's more to the way to make their conditions where a human being could feel himself comfortable. I mean, that's the way it is showed now, that a human should take this spacesuit, should get into the launch vehicle, should have these gravity problems and so on. It's not working, because no one could live in these conditions no more than, I don't know, 3-4 months, because it's really, really challenging and it's really tough for human body and for human being.
Right.
But it is possible to make the conditions with gravity. There is technologies which exist already. It is possible to support sustainable gravity, sustainable life, sustainable, I don't know, fields, houses and everything there. It's just a question of the time, technologies and how much people are involved in this.
So wow, I'm already picturing, you know, all of these scenarios that you see in science fiction movies, you know, one of the last ones, The Martian, for example, where they go and they set up this, you know, this camp, some kind of camp in Mars, and they can actually survive there and this. But how really, I mean, is that a reality? Really?
You know, that's the point, because you said survive. I don't want people to survive in space, because in that way we won't develop space, because people should live there comfortably. And it's possible, it's reality, just a question to go step by step to do this. Because can you imagine, just for that moment in space, only around 570 people have been in space. It's nothing. I mean, it's nothing compared with
the population of the world up to this point. Sure.
And the space could be habitable when more people, when 1,000, 2,000, 100,000 could go there.
Okay.
And it's a question the same if you could imagine when in 1950s first commercial airlines appeared, and only like some people could afford this because it was expensive, and no one could imagine that you could fly like in London to New York like in few hours, and like it's now it costs quite not expensive for everyone.
Well, if you ask people like Branson or Elon Musk, flying to space is also something that you could buy a ticket for.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. And I'm really, it's really great that such projects like what is doing Elon Musk or Branson or Jeff Bezos, they appeared, because it makes this community and it makes this technology to raise. And when it's raised, it's the effect of growth, and it becomes cheaper mm-hmm. and cheaper, and could be affordable for many people.
Would you book a ticket on SpaceX? Yeah, for sure, right?
For me, I would like to make this mixture of the projects, because we have our own launch vehicles to be prepared, and we have our own spaceship which are doing But the biggest thing is to make space like union for different companies, technologies and countries, and not to be a place just, I don't know, for SpaceX or just a place for China. It should be a union for everyone, and that's the way it could be developed.
Which brings us then to Galactica Group.
In Galactica we have three main directions. The first one is R&D and technologies. It's the projects that we are doing and technologies that we are making. At that moment, it's more 3D printing for space launchers and communication satellites and data satellites. Second part is this community and this unification, this international community which could be gathered between companies, people, enthusiasts about space, and in order to raise awareness, to raise technologies, and to make this mixture to create global projects. And the third part, it's more about education and entertainment, because I think that a very important part is how people see space, what's it about, and how it could be.
Where's that line, right, between enticing people's fantasy and reality?
You know, reality is when you go step by step and implementing your project. So, for example, okay, one of the steps in my vision, in my project, is settling up a moon base and settling up an intermediate station which could serve as both a service station and as a small hotel. It's reality because hotels...
A small hotel.
Yeah, because if you check up all the, I don't know, the history or... new projects. There are lots of projects of making small hotels on the orbit. One of them is using ISS, International Space Station, as part of it, and it's reality because, of course, it's expensive now. But if you make more modules, you can make a reduction in price, so it could be affordable to more people. So it would cost not like 30 million euros to get into space now, like it costs now, but okay, 5 million. Then it will be 1 million. And it's reality. The moon base, for example, if it is going like step by step also, so if you first settle up a small house, a small base there, then you make it bigger, check the production, check the robotics there, make flights between moon and Earth, it's also reality because it could be possible already now because there are technologies which exist for this.
All right, so we're not so far off.
Yeah, not very far.
Ah, that's very exciting. Now, in the US, of course, we've mentioned, or in Europe too, you know, we mentioned Branson earlier, Musk. Space is an area that's getting more and more privatized. Of course, traditionally, it was government-based, government-backed. Now it's becoming more and more privatized. Is this also the case in the former Soviet Union?
Yes, of course, it's the case because it changed a lot since Soviet Union times, and in Russia there are lots of now commercial opportunities, venture markets, investment markets, and it's all going to more private projects in different fields, and of course space is one of it. It was lots of things which were made by the government recently, and there are private companies which started to appear in Russia. Of course, it's not like in US when there are hundreds and thousands of space companies, but still there are in Russia. The great thing that I'm also involved in these activities because I would like to change the climate in Russia, the investment climate, the venture climate, and the opportunities for small companies, for student startups to appear.
What is the climate like in space?
The climate now is good because we have this venture campus called Skolkovo. It's kind of small Silicon Valley where they provide different opportunities for startups and companies, different support, I mean financial and different activation support and incubation. So it is possible to do things. And we are now in the discussion to make the laws, the same laws that implemented in the United States in order to have access to technologies, in order to make this possibility to do joint projects with Russian space agency. So it's in this discussion now and it's going to happen.
Do you have to work a lot in conjunction with the government? I mean, do you feel like you can act independently as a private organization?
Of course, we try to work independently because it's just a question of time. Of time, it's faster to work independently. And some things are connected with government, for example, launch sites, they're connected at that moment. Licenses, like some tests, it's all connected. And We have a couple of advisors from government who help with our project. I mean, scientific advisors, engineering advisors. So it's not very deep mixture, but we take advice. I would name it like this.
And Switzerland. What do you hear about Switzerland? What do you find when you travel here? Because you come here, as you said, often.
Yeah. In Switzerland, what is great, because we are not far from YPFL. It's the big university where they had developed different technologies for communication satellites, for small satellites, for engines. And I think that in Switzerland they have a great climate to also to grow up and to develop technologies. What I like here is that they are very precise to different details and to different projects. And here today in the SeedStars Summit, it's a great way to see all the startups and all these people who are engaged in these technologies. And that's great that we can combine all this and to make space happen.
What, I assume that you have a long list of things that you want to get done at Galactica Group. This is from what I understand. What's at the top of that list right now for you?
At the top of the list, there are three things. The first thing is to make first successful launches for our launch vehicles and to test successfully our 3D printer in the space in order that we could make bigger space constructions and make things built in space. Second thing is Space Center where we would like to combine different entertainment, historical, educational things about space. And I'm thinking now about the place where I would like to build it, because I think it should be either Russia or Europe. So I'm thinking now, because it really will be the project which will be compared with anything else which already exists, like Space Disneyland, it's so called. And the third thing, which is most important for me, is this community engaged for space habitation, for this space settlements happen. So this community engagement is going on now, so I would like to gain this international community.